Magandang araw, kapamilya. Today is Friday of the first week in Ordinary Time. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. Upon a lofty throne, I saw a man seated, whom a host of angels adore, singing in unison, "Behold him, the name of whose empire is eternal."
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. Attend to the pleas of your people with heavenly care, O Lord, we pray, that they may see what must be done and gain strength to do what they have seen. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Let us be on our guard while the promise of entering into his rest remains, that none of you seem to have failed. For in fact, we have received the good news just as our ancestors did. But the word that they heard did not profit them, for they were not united in faith with those who listened. For we who believed enter into that rest, just as he has said, "As I swore in my wrath, they shall not enter into my rest." And yet his works were accomplished at the foundation of the world. For he has spoken somewhere about the seventh day in this manner, "And God rested on the seventh day from all his works." And again, in the previously mentioned place, "They shall not enter into my rest." Therefore, let us strive to enter into that rest, so that no one may fall after the same example of disobedience. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Let our response be, "Do not forget the works of the Lord."
Do not forget the works of the Lord.
What we have heard and know, and what our fathers have declared to us, we will declare to the generation to come, the glorious deeds of the Lord and his strength.
Do not forget the works of the Lord.
That they too may rise and declare to their sons, that they should put their hope in God, and not forget the deeds of God, but keep his commands.
Do not forget the works of the Lord.
And not be like their fathers, a generation wayward and rebellious, a generation that kept not its heart steadfast, nor its spirit faithful toward God.
Do not forget the works of the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia. A great prophet has arisen in our midst, and God has visited his people. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
When Jesus returned to Capernaum after some days, it became known that he was at home. Many gathered together so that there was no longer room for them, not even around the door, and he preached the word to them. They came bringing to him a paralytic carried by four men. Unable to get near Jesus because of the crowd, they opened up the roof above him. After they had broken through, they let down the mat on which the paralytic was lying. When Jesus saw their faith, he said to him, "Child, your sins are forgiven." Now some of the scribes were sitting there asking themselves, "Why does this man speak that way? He is blaspheming. Who but God alone can forgive sins?" Jesus immediately knew his mind, what they were thinking to themselves. So he said, Why are you thinking such things in your hearts? Which is easier to say to the paralytic, your sins are forgiven, or to say, rise, pick up your mat, and walk? But that you may know that the Son of Man has authority to forgive sins on earth, he said to the paralytic, I say to you, rise, pick up your mat, and go. He rose, picked up his mat at once, and went away in the sight of everyone. They were all astounded and glorified God, saying, we have never seen anything like this. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You know, today you have, the way I would invite you to reflect on this Gospel is that here you have a sense of community that is formed, and a sense of community that brings about healing to the community. And of course, the striking part of this story is that the four men, the four friends of the paralytic, you know, how much trouble they took to bring the paralytic to Christ. You know? Imagine, it was very, very crowded. And as the story tells us, they went up the roof, opened the roof, and then lowered the paralytic. And I think that is for me a very good reminder to us that there is a saying that nobody goes to heaven alone. And I think this is really the invitation to us to become a community together, to become a community of faith together, and as a community of faith to become a healing community. And I think especially this particular year, there's a special significance. As I had mentioned last week, the special significance is that we will celebrate the 500 years of the coming of Christianity to the Philippines. We will celebrate 500 years of the Philippine Church. And perhaps during this celebration, this year of celebration, we can pray that we may truly become a community that will heal together, that will bring especially our most marginalized and needy and suffering brothers and sisters to Christ, that we become channels of God's grace, that we become the instruments of God in His hands to bring people to healing and to bring people to Christ. Siguro ho yun yung nais ko lang anyayahan kayong pagnilayan ngayong araw. Na alam natin na yung kasabihan nga, di ba, na walang taong nagpupunta sa langit na nag-iisa. Na sama-sama, di ba, community yung nagtumutungo sa langit, nagtutulungan tayong makaabot sa langit. At ngayon, lalo na sa ikalimang daan taon ng Kristyanismo, ng simbahan dito sa Pilipinas, siguro mahalaga na tayo ay magnilay, mag-isip, at siguro mag-usap-usap kung paano tayo pwedeng maging isang komunidad, isang simbahan na tunay na kumakalinga sa isa't isa. Kumakalinga at nagiging daan ng paghilom ng bawat isa sa atin. Hindi lang paghilom bilang mga individual, kundi paghilom bilang isang komunidad, bilang isang sambayan at bilang isang simbahan. And today, that is the challenge that we face. It is the challenge that we become truly a church that is really a presence of Christ healing in the world. Just like the four men in the gospel for today, will we become people who will be the channel of God's healing grace to other people? And today we pray for that. We pray that the Lord may bless us with that faith, and that may bless us with that openness to God's grace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
With all the trust of the paralytic's friends, let us bring to the Lord the needs and miseries of the church and of the world. To each prayer, our response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Spirit may guide the church in carrying out Christ's mission to preach forgiveness of sins to all who seek God's mercy. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may foster peace in the hearts of men and women by our readiness to forgive and forget past offenses. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
that we may be ready to bring Christ especially to those whose lives were shattered by painful circumstances. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick and the handicapped may continue to hope and to trust in God who wishes wholeness for everyone. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our departed brethren may have fullness of life in heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for the forgiveness shown to us by your Son. May we in turn show forgiveness to all who have offended us. We make our prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. To your goodness we have this bread and this wine to offer. Fruit of the earth, fruit of the vine, and work of human hands, they will become for us our spiritual food, our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
May your people's oblation, O Lord, find favor with you, we pray, that it may restore them to holiness and obtain what they devoutly entreat through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. With love we celebrate his death. With living faith we proclaim his resurrection. With unwavering hope we await his return in glory. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks, he broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, again he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and all the saints who have blessed you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and bring us and keep us mercy from sin and protect us from all anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And together let us pray the Oratio Imperata.
Almighty ever-living God, source of all mercy and compassion, we come to you in these times of dire need and tremendous suffering. The lives of your people are beset by grave tribulation, brought about by the COVID-19. We ask you now to look upon us with love and by your healing hand, dispel the fear of sickness and death, restore our hope and strengthen our faith. We pray for all health workers who are the frontliners in this fight for survival, doctors, nurses, hospital staff and personnel who have themselves fallen under the weight of their immense duties and responsibilities in serving those who are infected with the disease. Grant them health in mind and body, strength in their commitment, protection from the disease, and for those who have succumbed to the sickness, eternal life in your heavenly kingdom. We pray for workers who tirelessly serve the needs of the people, those in authority in keeping peace and security, and those responsible in leading us to defeat this terrible scourge. Keep them strong and constant in their commitment in the midst of this difficult battle. We pray for those who have been infected by the virus, the dying and those who have died in agony and loneliness. Let their suffering be their participation in the suffering of your Son. We thank you now for two effective vaccines launched recently and the powerful therapeutics now also on deck. Things have become possible only by your guiding hands. We pray for continuing health and safety of the people, particularly the frontliners leading our crusade against the COVID-19 pandemic and complete recovery of the victims of this malady. We pray that we will be completely well and will be restored to our normal lives. We ask all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son and our divine healer, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers. O glorious and ever-blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
Saint Roch.
Pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu.
Have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy.
Have mercy on us.
And let us pray. Humbly we ask you, Almighty God, be graciously pleased to grant that those you renew with your sacraments may also serve with lives pleasing to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
We'd like to invite you, no, very, very specially invite you this weekend for Journeys of Hope. This weekend, being the Feast of the Santo Niño, we will have a two-part series of Journeys of Hope this weekend and next weekend. And we have three guests this weekend, Dr. Leloy Claudio, Dr. J.L. Cornelio, and Mr. Carlos Santiago. They're all, you might say, not just students of history, but experts in history. And our topic will be about the Philippine Church, no? and really the journey of our people, considering that we are going to celebrate this year 500 years of Christianity. Dr. Leloy Claudio is now teaching in UC Berkeley. His field really is, I believe, Southeast Asian Studies. But very, very passionate, very, very patriotic and nationalistic student of history. And Dr. Cornelio is, his specialization is really, he wrote a book, 2017, I think, Being Catholic in Contemporary Philippines and how the youth are in a sense, interpreting or reinventing religion, the practice of Catholicism. And Mr. Carlos Santiago is also you know, has written many articles and has given talks even in ABS on history. So please join us in this special two-part series, and I am sure that you'll be able to a lot of food for thought, especially as we prepare for the 500 years of Christianity in the Philippines. And also this year is the 35th anniversary of EDSA. It is also the 125th anniversary of the martyrdom of Rizal. No? So much to think about our country and our church. So please join us. So happy weekend.